Thank you very much for joining us. I'm Jimmy Rabin. I'm the Fortify Senior Product Manager. I'm here today to talk about how we are leveraging machine learning to automatically audit vulnerabilities, reduce false positives, and scale auditing. So if you're familiar with the static analysis security testing process, typically, developers check code into a repository. There's some type of schedule to trigger checkout and build. Static analysis is integrated into that build step where it's automatically scanned. And then typically you have this loop where auditors audit those issues, right? So they decide what issues are true positives or false positives or whatever the organizational's context around risk is, right? And they assign those vulnerabilities an analysis tag typically, where issues can be submitted to a vulnerability management system and ultimately be assigned to a developer to fix issues. When you look at static analysis programs, the majority of the time spent is on auditing. It's without a doubt, this is a 10 out of a 10 in terms of time, nine parts of that are the audit process. Static analysis scales very well. It's very easy to automate. It's very fast, even for complex, large systems. But auditing takes a special skill set, and it takes quite a bit of time to review, especially when you're baselining or the first time you've run a scan, to run a scan and to triage all of those issues. So what we at Fortify have done as you look through the audit process, there's a number of different reasons why an auditor would choose to fix, not fix an issue, right? A true positive or false positive in the context of that auditor or that organization. There could be mitigations in place. The code could not be reachable. It could be an internal app you don't care about, or it could be, not an actual technical false positive, right? A technical decision around false positives and false negatives. The type of data that we're going to provide to you falls into the far right, the false positive idea. We provide the security expertise, as we'll talk about here in a minute. And you and your organization can actually provide us the application context and the organizational preference. And I'll explain that all as we go through this. So the way Audit Assistant works, right? We train these algorithms using audited data. So in our Fortify on Demand static analysis offering, we offer security subject matter experts who audit your scans every day. We take those hundreds upon hundreds of thousands of audit decisions, and we use that to train algorithms. We can also train those algorithms using your own data, right? So then we fingerprint the issues, right? And we can return a prediction. So we take anonymized metadata about your issues, not the source code themselves, and we match that to past decisions that we've made, right, with our incredibly large data set of audited results, and provide you a prediction of whether something is a true positive or false positive, allowing you to automatically triage a subset of your issues and save innumerable time. When you look at the cost that subject matter experts in this field, they're very limited, they're scarce, they're hard to retain. And so using their knowledge to then extrapolate that and predict future results is a huge advantage that Fortify is bringing to static analysis and something that you can take advantage of. You can see here we can return predictions, the confidence value, and focus. You can focus on what actually counts and push these automatically to a developer to be fixed, right? So this scales, right? It is completely automatable. We have an API, and I'll show you the workflow in terms of what we brought in terms of automation. And it really allows us to speed up the triage process, which I mentioned before is the number one time, the number one place you're going to consume a lot of resources is on the auditing side. So we're going to take a look at an application version in SSC. You'll see up here, there is the Audit Assistant button. That allows us to go ahead and request a prediction from Audit Assistant. First, there's a small configuration step here where you provide an authentication token, the URL for Audit Assistant, and the policy that you wish to use. We provide a global Fortify policy that you can use, which is basically all of our data, all of the algorithm that we provide that's already got all of our training data available. You click this button right here if you want to auto apply results. So that allows us to go ahead and automatically triage those issues for you so you don't have to manually do so. So I've got auto apply selected here. And all we need to do then is go look at our project. And there is a setting to enable it here. So enable auto apply. All right. And once that happens, what we can do is click Audit Assistant. And that is going ahead and fingerprinting all of the issues. It is sending that to the scan analytics backend that we provide. And it's going to then send us back an artifact that will have the AA underscore naming convention. And that is going to contain the metadata of our predictions for our untriage results. So if we look in group by Audit Assistant prediction, we can see that 42 of our issues have been deemed exploitable by Audit Assistant. 78 of those issues have been deemed not an issue. We can see here that Audit Assistant did finish processing and did provide us with the Audit Assistant metadata that we're looking at. And we can see some that fall below the threshold and a few issues that we don't predict on. Data flow issues and control flow issues in Fortify have a lot of rich data that we can use to match to appropriate decisions. So those are the types of issues that we offer predictions on. So the majority of the issues here are fall not into those. Those are structural or semantic type issues. So if we go ahead and look under the exploitable prediction, you can see here that it's already been tagged, and you can see the little gavel here. That indicates that we automatically tagged this issue. So the prediction marked it as exploitable, and we marked it as exploitable here. This allows us, if we click here and look at the comments in history, we can see that the value of the attribute was set to exploitable because of enabled auto apply. So the machine learning and the automation in SSC is responsible for this audit. And a developer could go ahead with a 99% confidence that this is a true issue, right, that is exploitable by an attacker and should be fixed, right, in the case of cross-site scripting, whether it's validating the input and a combination of correct output encoding for the right context. So we can also look at not an issue and see all of the issues here that are not issues and that most likely a developer would not want to investigate or even or to apply a fix. So we can see that we've saved a significant amount of time in the context of this application, right? We've triaged, you know, well over a third of the issues with 99% accuracy using our past decisions on the issues that were found in this custom scan that we've run. So we fingerprinted those issues and matched it to the back end. I will show you one other configuration. All right, so if we look at our tags here, we do provide a where you can map any tag value to the Audit Assistant mapping, and that's how we determine what to tag a predicted issue with. So if you have custom tags, this works just fine. You just need to come in here and assign the tag. You can also see here for training, we've mapped analysis tags to whether those are true positive or not issues. So anytime you audit yourself, anytime you change an analysis tag from exploitable to not an issue, right? Anytime you use Audit Assistant, we also collect that information as well, right? So if you're leveraging our community data, you're also helping to improve it at the same time. All right, well, hopefully you will be leveraging Audit Assistant in the future. There is an API endpoint available for this send to Audit Assistant button here. So if you wish to add this to your CI script, we have an easy sample that you can use on our GitHub page, github.com/fortify in the JavaScript sandbox, and that'll help you automate requesting for predictions, and then auto apply will help you automatically tag them. Hope you will see some of the value that we've shown here, and you'll leverage this to really accelerate your security program. Thank you very much.